Hello everybody, welcome to the next segment of the Volo Performance Chips. Which this one, I think I mentioned before, is for fuel economy instead of performance. So, we are going to do the installation now. And to do that, it's supposed to start by unscrewing our OBD2 port. And we are supposed to take a look what sockets have wires in them. And then we'll go back over to their nice handy application they have on their website. See how that, what's all up with that. Huh. That's not right. Wonder where that came from. Oh, it must be from my remote start. Sorry about the blockage there. I'm trying to figure out where this thing goes into. Oh, okay. Does not unscrew for this car. A little different than my other one. This one's got pressures. Try and squeeze, which are always a pain in the ass. Pop that up. Bend that out of the way. And there we go. There's our OBD2 port. Better put this little bugger back. Like to keep my remote start working. Now, like I say, I apologize for the lack of view. There isn't much room to work in this vehicle. A dash, but what car is it? What car is there that's really easy to get at? It's besides a Lincoln Navigator, which could probably fit an elephant in the front seat of one of them things, which I think I have seen. This is Wisconsin, by the way. Lots of elephants walking around. Alright, so we got, I'll have to cut that sheathing back a bit. Careful not to slice any wires. Slice all these out. I'll hold this off, but there we go. There's our wires. All right, now I guess we have to decide, or we have to mark which prongs are populated. So I better get the owner's manual out. They have a nice little diagram in there. Our handy dandy owner's manual. To determine protocol, look for the front of the port. Write down which of the following pins are populated. Have metal, contact, or wire present. So, I guess pin one. Better mark that on this book here. Be patient with me, like all you. I am learning at the same time as you are. That's pin one. Two and three are empty. Four and five. Six, seven are empty. And number eight. Second row would be 9 and 10. 11 is empty. 12 and 13. are populated, 14, 15, and 16 are empty. So, what do we got here? Alright, now we're going to go back to the computer and find out which spots the wires go on to. Now, I can determine that from inside the owner's manual here. However, they have a custom verification thing or something along those lines. I forget exactly what they call it, but we're going to give that a try. And yes, my truck needs to be vacuumed out. So, get a shot of the pins if we can. 1, 2, 3... Okay. 1, 2, and 3 are empty. 4, 5. Now, each vehicle can be a little different, depending on year, make, and model. Models of the same year, like all 2002 Xterras, obviously are going to be the same. Maybe a 2001 Xterra might be different from a 2002, as would a 2013 or 14 Xterra. But there are no 14s yet, so definitely different than the 14s because they're not even making them yet. So let's wrote down the pins. Oh, and you guys don't need to see that. All right. Next video will be determining which wires go to which pins.